By convention, there are two HTTP methods that are used whenever we're updating resources, and those are called put and patch. With put, updates are issued by replacing entire resources, but with patch, we can update individual properties inside of a given resource. That means that for put requests, we usually have to contain that entire resource inside of the message body, but for patch, we just have to define the individual properties and the associated update operation. In this video, I want to show you how we can apply some of those incremental updates using something called JSON Patch. There you go, you probably guessed it, there's a spec for that. JSON Patch is a spec that defines how we can issue updates to resources inside of our web APIs. And it's defined in spec RFC 6902. So if you want to look it up, you can go ahead and search for that. Now, JSON Patch defines operations such as add, remove, replace, or even move. And if we want to implement this inside of ASP.NET Core, we just have to install a few Nuget packages. So let's go ahead and take a look. Support for JSON Patch isn't enabled by default inside of our web API templates. So there's a few Nuget packages that we need to install. First, make sure you install the Microsoft ASP.NET Core JSON Patch package. Next, install the Microsoft ASP.NET Core.mvc.newtonsoft.json package as well. These two are needed to enable that JSON patch support inside of our web API. Lastly, make sure you install the swashbuckle.asp.net core.newtonsoft package. We need that to make sure that JSON patch support works inside of our Swagger UI. Next, let's head over to the startup.cs file to enable these features. On line 32, notice I'm adding a call to add newtonsoft JSON. Also on line 37, we're enabling newtonsoft support for our Swagger UI by another method call. Last thing we need to do is actually update our controller. Now, you might notice that I have a few extra methods inside of here, but I want us to pay attention to the update recipe action method. On line 51, you can notice that I'm including a routing parameter of ID. This is going to represent the ID of the recipe that I want to update. In a parameter list, you can also see that I'm accepting a type of JSON patch document. This type became available to us after we installed some of those NuGet packages. Now, inside of my action method, I just need to retrieve that resource, and then on line 59, I can call apply to, and that's gonna apply all those JSON patch updates to my recipe. Next, we just have to persist that to the database and then hopefully return a successful response. Why don't we head over to the Swagger UI and try this out? First thing I wanna do inside of the Swagger UI is let's check out this get method. Now, this particular get method is gonna return a single recipe. I'm going to paste in the ID of a recipe that I know I want to get. As we scroll down, notice this one says the best meatballs in the title. What do we use JSON patch to update that title? So let's go to the patch. I'm going to hit try out. And as you can imagine, I have to give it the ID of the recipe I want to update. But now inside of the body, I have to specify the updates I want to make. So I want to update the title. I want to replace it. And then instead of from, I'm going to make this value. And the value I want to change this to is 30 minute meatballs. There we go. Now I'm going to execute that. And as we scroll down, I got a 200 level status code. So I hope that means that everything's working fine. Let's come back to our get operation and let's issue this request against that particular recipe. And once I run it, there you go. You can see that the title has been updated. So therefore, that means that our JSON patch request has worked. And now you know how to enable incremental updates to your web API resources using JSON patch. As an exercise for yourself, why don't you try doing another update instead with an HTTP put?